Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about potassium in relationship to your cardiovascular system. This little video is based on a really cool article that I put down there to download. If you have any cardiovascular problems, you need to read this article. This is called The New Guideline for Potassium Replacement in Clinical Practice. It's a group of cardiologists who formed the National Council on Potassium, and they show the importance of potassium for the cardiovascular system. So I want to just kind of cover some of the summaries in what potassium can do. First of all, if you have a potassium deficiency, the name of that disorder is called hypokalemia. Hypo, and you can remember it by kale, K-A-L-E, right? Hypokalemia, that's low potassium. Now, if you have a potassium deficiency, you might feel tired, leg cramps, muscle weakness, constipated, tremor, because potassium is intimately involved with muscle physiology, nerve physiology, and cardiovascular physiology. So you can also have atrial fibrillation, which is a rhythm problem of the heart, high blood pressure. In fact, in most cases of high blood pressure, there is a potassium deficiency. And what do they give you? A diuretic. What does diuretics do? Most of them deplete potassium. So it's like a never-ending cycle. And then also, if you're low on potassium, you will have a higher pulse rate. Potassium lowers your pulse rate. Okay, so now the question is, how could you possibly get a potassium deficiency, right? Well, here are some of the causes. One is maybe too much sodium, because when you increase sodium, you naturally decrease potassium because they work together. But maybe it's not potassium. Maybe it's low magnesium. So when you, magnesium is necessary to keep potassium in the right balance, and that comes from vegetables, all right? Insulin, high insulin. So let's say you have insulin resistance or you're diabetic. Do you know that you're not going to be able to absorb potassium that well? And that's why there's all these edema and fluid issues. In fact, it takes potassium to heal the insulin dysfunction. You can almost correct insulin resistance and improve your blood sugars by taking potassium. Fascinating. And then, of course, too much sugar from the spike insulin will actually deplete potassium. Too many refined carbs will do it. That's why if you consume a lot of sugar, all of a sudden your pulse rate starts going higher. Also, high cortisol, that's the stress. Also, in a medication called prednisone, that can also deplete your potassium. Of course, you have the diarrhea and vomiting to some degree. And then also a condition called alkalosis. Alkalosis is when your body is just too alkaline. And I know you've been taught that people need to just alkalize the body and all this stuff. Well, actually, when you go through a lot of stress and you have high levels of cortisol, your adrenal body type, your pH becomes more on the alkaline side. Your blood pH becomes excessively alkaline, and that's called alkalosis. And one of the symptoms is a potassium deficiency. Interesting, right? Surgery and trauma. When they do a major abdominal surgery, they're always watching for potassium, because if that potassium goes down when you're under the under surgery and you're already deficient in potassium, you can create some serious problems with the heart. So that's why they usually give you a potassium IV when you go through surgery. And then trauma. I remember I had a bike accident, went over the handlebars, and I landed in the cement, and my potassium just went down to zero. And I think because when you go through stress, it spikes adrenaline. Adrenaline will decrease potassium too. And then we have low hydrochloric acid. When you don't have enough acid in your stomach, you can't absorb potassium. And then you have potassium problems. So it takes potassium to keep the stomach acids correct. And also, taking potassium will help you digest and create stomach acid. So in other words, low potassium can create low hydrochloric acid, but then adding acid back in can help you absorb potassium. Drinking too much water can deplete your potassium, because water is not necessarily filled with electrolytes. So you take too much water, you drink a gallon, and you deplete the last bit of potassium you have, and then you end up with all sorts of dehydration problems, right? Diuretic, that's another cause of potassium deficiencies, and that comes from when you're on high blood pressure, they give you a diuretic, and then you become potassium deficient. And then you stay you continue to have high blood pressure. Crazy. So in this article that I want you to download, these doctors are recommending potassium to prevent and even correct a lot of the cardiovascular problems. And potassium has the potential to keep your arteries elastic, decrease the risk of a stroke, and potassium can protect the kidney and even the heart. So this whole idea that if you have a kidney problem, you absolutely must stay away from potassium is not necessarily true unless it's a severe case. Now, how do you get potassium? Beet tops, okay? But if you don't like beet tops, you just need to start to increase your salad to 7 to 10 cups of salad. Why? Because it takes that much potassium, and we need a lot, like close to 4,700 milligrams. Potassium is also good for rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory conditions. So you can see this mineral is vital. So for more information about nutrition and health and how to create a healthy body, check out my website at drberg.com. I'll see you there.